I'm joined now by the author and journalist Jon Wilde. Nice to see you, Jon.
Pleasure to be here.
Are you surprised that Brighton's the most stressed or have the most stressed people in the UK?
I think yes and no. I think anyone who comes to Brighton would probably remark just how chilled out it seems. But as with anything, anywhere you go these days, I mean, you only have to scratch the surface. And, you know, we're living in times where there's an epidemic of stress and anxiety and depression. And you've only got to sit on the bus in Brighton, which I do regularly. I travel regularly by bus. And there just seems to be an awful lot of anxiety about, despite the fact that we live in this really beautiful town, you know, with so much going for it, it's so tolerant and everything like that. Again, you've just got to scratch the surface. And there's a lot of lives out there that are kind of unsustainable in terms of the levels of anxiety, the weight of anxiety that people are carrying.
Mm. And you're very much speaking from your own experience, because we're going to talk about your mindfulness book, which
sure.
is out. But you're known as a music journalist, and I mean, and one of the best. And you've been doing it for a long time, and you really hit the heights, didn't you, your music journalism? I mean, you've interviewed people like Paul McCartney and
yeah,
Hollywood A-listers. And...
Yeah, I mean, I kind of worked at the top end, so, you know, it'd be 3 days in L.A. with Paul McCartney, just hanging out, interviewing him for hours and hours and hours. It would be not just musicians, it would be athletes, it would be, you know, Usain Bolt, and it would be politicians, Boris Johnson, George Osborne, people like that. But music was always kind of like the main area of interest for me. And back in the day, certainly, I mean, going on the road with a band like Guns N' Roses, for example, I spent the best part of a week with them. There's many a salty story to be told about, you know, those times, I'll say. But here's the thing. On the face of it, Brighton, in a way, is a kind of metaphor for my life as I lived it. On the surface, people would look at my life and go, there he is, off again, off to L.A. to hang out with Robert Downey Jr. or Denzel Washington or Drew Barrymore, whoever. Underneath it all, I was utterly miserable, and I was utterly miserable for most of my adult life. My life was ruled by anxiety, depression. I was never really present in my life. It was always about stuff I was worried about ruled my life. And it was always about the next thing. The next job was going to make me happy. The next relationship was going to make me happy. And I was barely showing up in my own life. And that changed about 6 years ago when I discovered mindfulness, started meditating. And from the first meditation, it was basically clear to me that this is what I'd been longing for all my life. And pretty soon after, I decided this is what I want my life to be. I'd found my new passion. You know, journalism had been my first passion. I discovered another passion at the age of 50, which is extraordinarily lucky to my mind. I feel absolutely blessed that sort of, you know, I mean, you're lucky to get one strike in your life, but I found this thing which not only I loved on a personal level, but also I found that, well, wait a minute, I could learn how to teach this. You know, I could learn to write about it, which I have done. I've just published this book called The Turning Point with my friend Gerard Evans. We co-wrote it. And that, in that book, I go into I'm teaching people how to meditate, how to learn about mindfulness, but I'm also talking about my own life and the struggles and what led me to meditation.
Mm.
It's been a colourful journey.
And are you still writing? I mean, is there, you know, is it like a case of, because I guess it's a very sort of egotistical lifestyle as a, you know, as a writer and being in that sort of industry, and whereas you're sort of turning towards yourself with the mindfulness, and I'd imagine much more, you're wanting a much more peaceful lifestyle. Are you able to cross over? Are you able to find a balance, or is it one or the other for you?
No, it's all about really kind of my life has kind of opened out. So it always used to be about my worries and you know, my next challenge and how anxious I'm feeling. There's two sides of the coin, really, with mindfulness. Mindfulness is built on compassion, self-compassion, but it's also built on compassion for others. And so these days, I mean, whereas in the past I'd hang out with Oliver Reed in Russia for 5 days and get steaming drunk with him and come back with bags of great stories, these days I'm much happier, in fact, sitting down with somebody in recovery in Brighton and talking to them about specifically about the transformation, about how they've managed to come from drinking 3 bottles of vodka a day or whatever it is to actually live in a life that is being lived in the present, that isn't about the next drink.
And more sustainable.
Yeah, because you know, living a life built on anxiety and depression is ultimately, as I found, it's unsustainable. It's an exhausting way to live, and we don't need to live this life. If only we can find a little bit of space in which to manoeuvre, space to breathe, space to pause, space to actually stop and appreciate that beautiful sunset or you know, the beautiful sea that I'm going to walk in by in a few minutes' time. In the past, I couldn't do that because I was so absorbed with my thoughts. I was living entirely inside my own head, and it's not a life I would recommend.
OK. So it's The Turning Point with Gerald Evans, and that is available on Amazon, is that right?
Through Amazon, yeah, absolutely.
OK. John, it's been fascinating talking to you.
Pleasure.
Thank you so much, and good luck with the book.
Thank you very much. Cheers.